From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Good evening and welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Megan Torgerson. A new survey from the Associated Press shows the five candidates running for governor are divided on same-sex marriage but have similar views on casino gambling in Maine. Democrat Libby Mitchell and Independent Elliot Cutler say they support efforts to recognize same-sex marriages. Republican Paula Page said he would not propose such a change because the voters have already spoken. Independent Sean Moody said he would not sign a gay marriage law unless it had a provision sending it to voters. Fellow Independent Kevin Scott said he would work with all sides. And as for casino gambling, which is on the ballot again here in Maine, Mitchell, Cutler, and Moody said they oppose it. Page would support the voters' decision if they endorse it. Scott said he'd work with the legislature to create a casino gambling law that works in Maine's best interest. A worker at a Sanford manufacturing plant was taken to the hospital following a small chemical spill this morning. The Sanford Fire Department says crews were called to the Syro Industries plant on Main Street around 8:30. Officials say an employee was accidentally sprayed with a chemical when it spilled from a tanker truck while it was being unloaded. About 20 gallons spilled, which workers clean up. The employee who was sprayed was taken to the Goodall Hospital as a precaution. Syro Industries is a plastics manufacturer. A Piscataquis County woman is recovering from serious injuries following an ATV crash in Blanchard Township last night. Maine game wardens say Jane Grant was riding with a friend on an ATV trail when she drove off an embankment and fell 25 feet into a small stream. Investigators say Grant's friend rode to get help but couldn't find the crash site. Search crews found Grant a little after midnight. She was taken to Eastern Maine Medical Center in Bangor with serious injuries to her head and body. A small earthquake in New Hampshire late last night sent tremors across that state through parts of Maine, Vermont, and Massachusetts. The U.S. Geological Survey says a 3.1 magnitude quake centered in Boscawen hit around 11:30. Boscawen is about 10 miles north of Concord. There were no reports of any damage or injuries. According to the USGS, residents reported feeling the earthquake across the southern half of New Hampshire, as well as southern Maine, northern Massachusetts, and southeastern Vermont. To kick off Down Syndrome Awareness Month, hundreds of walkers filled Payson Park in Portland. The goal is to raise money for research and acceptance of the genetic condition. The National Buddy Walk was one of more than 250 planned across the country. This is Portland's 10th year participating in the event, organized by the National Down Syndrome Society. The first ever took place in Augusta today as well. Friends, family, and supporters came out to help the cause.
Excellent turnout. I haven't done the final count, but we're looking up over 500 people right now, and great fundraising happening and really great friendships being made and lots of fun to be had.
The goal was to raise $20,000 today. Before the walk even started, organizers say donations were more than half of that. All funds raised through the Buddy Walk support both local and national programs. Thank you for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Megan Torgerson.